What's up, YouTube? I'm Guy, and today we're talking Seiko again. You know, every time I think I've covered the Seiko topic, they announce something new, and they double down, pulling me right back in. Well, as it turns out, today we have two things to cover. Now, I had originally planned to talk about the discontinuation of the SKX Diver and the subsequent replacement with the new Seiko 5 models, and we'll get to that topic here towards the end of the video. But first, some news I saw yesterday. They have a new Seiko Presage model featuring a spring drive movement with enamel dial at a price of $4,500. What? Seiko's introducing a new model in the Presage line of watches, the reference SNR037 and 39, which feature 5R series spring drive movements and a white or black enamel dial on a leather strap. The kicker is, of course, the price. Now, I've been saying it for over a year. I've been thinking it for even longer, but Seiko is changing in a major way. They're pushing all of their product lines upmarket, and I've asked in the past, have they jumped the shark? Now I know, the Seiko apologists, they're gonna roll into the comments and they're gonna justify the push to move the brand upmarket, saying things like their watches are undervalued and they're just charging the prices that they deserve. So let me get this straight. You want watches to be more expensive? I mean, if you're a watch dealer, I guess I can see your point. But as a consumer, this line of thinking is bordering on insane. They're also going to say, but it has an enamel dial. Don't you know how hard it is to make an enamel dial? The reference SPB075 had an enamel dial with a limited production of 2,500 pieces and it was $1,400. The Presage SPB047 has an enamel dial and came in at a price of just $1,000. Clearly, the enamel dial on the new model doesn't justify its $4,500 asking price. I know, but it has a spring drive movement. That's true, it does have a spring drive movement, but it's an undecorated 5R series spring drive, and that doesn't justify the $3,500 premium over those other watches, in my opinion. It's an undecorated hybrid quartz movement with a date complication and a power reserve indicator. It's not a hand-decorated tourbillon. This should probably be a $2,500 watch, at most, and be positioned as an entry point to the spring drive movement and a gateway to the Grand Seiko line. But in reality, it directly competes with Grand Seiko watches, at least for now. Why do I say, quote-unquote, for now? Well, it's clear what Seiko's doing here. They're incrementally pushing their lower-tier product lines up market. It's a bottom-up approach. And, mark my words, in the next few years, Grand Seiko watches are going to escalate to silly price levels as well. If you're in the market for a watch at the $4,000 and up price point, the moral of the story is this. Skip this watch and buy a Grand Seiko before it's too late. Now that brings us to the Seiko SKX discussion. I've had a bunch of people ask me, what do I think about the new Seiko 5 model dive watches? Well, honestly, I don't think too much. The word on the street is that the SKX model has been discontinued, and it would appear that in its place we're given a selection of about 27 new watches that are in several ways worse than the original SKX, but cost more money. This is just like the Presage watch that we talked about a minute ago, Seiko pushing their entry and mid-tier watches up market. Now, something that I find unappealing about this move is the sheer number of variations. 27 different versions is the number that I've seen advertised, and this comes across to me as a cry for desperation from the brand. They probably aren't gonna sell this watch to a million people, but they might get a bunch of people to buy 2, 3, or even more different versions of the watch. It's a term my buddy AB from the Watch Collecting Strategy YouTube channel described as fast fashion, and I think he's right. Personally, I find it questionable, as it dilutes the range in a way that makes each individual model a lot less special. Now, the prices I've seen quoted for these watches were in euros, but converted to USD, they range from $275 to $375. At the top of that range, it's significantly overpriced. You can pick up a Seiko 5 SNZF17 for plus or minus $150, and these new models aren't any better by my estimation. Yes, they have a 4R series movement instead of the 7S movement found in the original SKX and the aforementioned SNZF, but with the exception of hand winding and hacking, which is nice, it's fundamentally the same movement as the 7S, and it's a movement that, frankly, I hate. The rest of the specs are all downgrades from the original SKX, and it makes these watches kind of a big disappointment. We're paying more and we're getting less, and frankly, that's never a good thing. Now, with that said, I can all but guarantee that we'll see a return of the SKX in the coming years, but it will probably be a ProSpecs line watch, maybe a limited edition, and it will have a price point of $700 or $800 at a minimum. And honestly, the way Seiko has been going lately, I might be grossly underestimating that number. I'm not a Seiko hater, I like a lot of their watches, but I do hate the way that Seiko has been positioning the brand recently, and I fully expect it to get worse. But I've been saying that for a year or more now, so it's really no surprise. Alright, thanks for tuning in, guys. As always, I appreciate it. That's gonna wrap this video up for today. Check the description of this video for my links. We're talking social media, Patreon, my Amazon, and my Audible affiliate links. A big thanks to everyone who's been supporting me and my channel, and a big thanks to all the subscribers and viewers of my content. Now, until the next one, I'll sign off and say bye now.